So, I'll tell you what, folks, it's a comedy show, and so at some point, I'm sure you'd like to see people get in a fight, because we're all comedians, that means we're dramatic. What better fight is there than a comedy fight? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Tim Work!
There we go. All right. It's time for Comedy Fight! Folks, this is our second year of Comedy Fight here at Die Laughing. What you are going to see is 16 comedians coming onto the stage and fighting with comedy. Now, how do you determine who wins comedy? Well, you bring in judges who know comedy, and I have four judges with me tonight who know comedy. Bring him on the stage right now. First up, he's going to be on this stage later this weekend, Brian Alexander. Here, you're the keeper of the mic for the judges, Brian. All right. Now, he has been on this stage already tonight, and he's going to be back tomorrow during May the Farce Be With You. Let's hear it for Chad Dutton. And then I think she's just here to judge Comedy Fight, which is awesome. Thank you for being here. Allison Winkler! And we kept him up late. Please put your hands together for Bill Steitler! Oh, Allison was in school late. I'm sorry, I was doing a show somewhere else, so I didn't see it. I apologize. So Allison is in school late. Bill is just in his pajamas. So thank you. All right. So the way this works, we have 16 performers. They are in two brackets of eight. If they lose in the first round, they move into a consolation bracket. So everybody will play at least two comedy fights. We will have three people in our final. So we have also a bucket of challenges. These are comedy fights that I have on these slips of paper. And they know what the comedy fights are, but they don't know what they mean. So it is their job to decide how to fight with comedy once they are told what their battle is. So we're going to start with Becky and Kyle. Becky and Kyle will have 1 minute to fight, and then the judges will determine which of the two of them is the victor. The loser still goes into the consolation bracket, so you still have a chance. Your fight is a gibberish off.
Master Coos, the boss, the bush, the bach, the bush, the bach, the bush, the bach.
Begin, begin. Beluga.
Beleg? Benumanog? Machine Manog, Machine Manog, Ratchet, you boss the booster.
Wait a minute.
I believe that's the end of our comedy fight right there. And now our judges have a very difficult task. They have to determine which of those two contestants won their gibberish off. And then, of course, the winner will move on. The loser moves into the consolation bracket. So there are no losers at this point. My judges, I need a winner.
Oh, do you need us to say something?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got a microphone. Yeah, okay.
This was particularly difficult for all of us, but I think it came down to the fact that in terms of pure gibberish, we had to give it to Becky because Kyle was clearly speaking Klingon.
Oh! That is a good point. That is a good point.
Completely agree with that assessment.
Kyle moves into the consolation bracket. We will move quickly to our second fight. Let's hear it for Becky and Kyle. Up next, we have Jason and Fur. Jason and Fur. Your fight, gentlemen, is a bad accent off.
Do you know what I love about this place?
Why?
The thing I love about this place is we usually don't let trash like you in.
Why in? Allow me to my pants.
No. You need to... No, I can't even look... No, not even at your face.
French or Italian, I can't tell.
How dare you insult me? You've been a bad, bad boy who needs a spanking.
The matrix isn't an accent.
All right, that's where we're going to stop it. Right there. Next year, this will be entitled Comedy Fight, subtitle, Dominatrix Isn't an Accent. Judges, I need to know who the winner of this fight is.
It was bad accent? Well, we could definitely understand your accent. You got the bad accent.
Oh, all right. So Fur moves on, again on a technicality. Jason moves into the consolation bracket. Next up, we have Duck versus Garrick. They are going to compete in a laugh-off. A laugh-off. I'm going to need to know who won that fight between Garrick and Duck in the laugh-off. I don't know, that's tough. Very, very difficult. They're two really extremely very disparate techniques.
We're going with Duck then.
Okay.
Duck was very clear and concise.
Garrick, you move into the consolation bracket. You still have a chance. All right, our final pairing in the first bracket, Tanya and John. You are going to engage in a circus off. I can watch this all night.
What else happens at a circus? Peanuts, lots of peanuts, and then there's clowns. Seriously, juggling?
I'm just juggling flaming meat cleavers right now.
How do you put the metal on fire? That's amazing.
Okay. Well, you know, a little kerosene, a little lack of, well, so I just cut myself right now.
So,
I put
clown seltzer bottle.
Ah! Ah! You challenge me to a seltzer duel, woman?
Yes.
Ah! Damn it! This is a new clown suit. These aren't cheap.
Well, no, but your makeup is.
Ooh. And that's the end of the circus fight. Judges.
This was really special. I felt like I was at the circus. But I think the one who truly captured the moment was Tanya when the elephant says, "Wait, I'm an elephant." So we're going to have to give this to Tanya.
She went for every single aspect of the circus. I agree.
Tanya moves on. John is going into the consolation bracket. Now, we're moving into round two in bracket one. We have Becky versus Fur. Becky versus Fur.
Oh, boy.
They are going to compete in a Harry Potter off.
Where would you like to start? Movies or books?
You pick. After
no, no,
you.
No, 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 no. Honey, pick. I'm giving you the option.
It's bullshit either way, so you go ahead.
All right.
Harry Potter's not a personality trait.
Okay, and that's what you feel. We've also realized that through Harry Potter, we've learned a ton of life lessons about not accepting truth just because an authoritative figure gives it to you. We've talked about accepting other people. We've talked about being used as a human being. There's so many concepts, but you want to belittle it because you don't like it. You go right ahead.
We also get cheap representations of people being thrown in it, you know, as it's convenient for J.K. Rowling. But that's okay.
Okay, you can have complaints about Harry Potter, that's fine, but dismissing an entire genre based on the concept that because she made Dumbledore gay, okay, yeah, no, that's a fair complaint about it. But there's a lot of other stuff. You can't negate all of the good stuff because there's one bad thing. I appreciate your criticism. I'm just saying that, like, you've just negated the whole thing because of it.
This is supposed to be funny, right?
Well, you That's absolutely fine. I gave you the option of picking movies and books, and then you turned this into a fight. So, yeah, it's my fault. You go right ahead.
You're done.
I'm good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you done, Becky? Okay, they're done.
Are
judges.
You guys married?
Judges, I need to know what you think. Who won that fight?
Huh? Should I just...
Okay, well, I would have totally done Dumbledore, so I agree with Becky. So I think Becky should probably...
Okay, Becky wins because she has a new Dumbledore. All right, so Fur is out of it. Becky is still in Duck versus Tanya. Duck versus Tanya. A monster off. Really?
Wait, I'm a monster? Because it was a monster, right? Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Right? let's see.
I want to suck your blood.
You do, huh?
Well,
I dare you.
Brains, but you don't seem to have any teeth.
No, I don't.
No, and you know, I want you to suck my blood, but you don't seem to have any teeth.
No, I lost them in an accident.
Yeah, and so I just don't know what to do without that monster.
Well, we should do Thriller.
Hold on. No, I can help. Just give me a second. If I'd known, I would have been ready. Alright, judges, if you don't know the one after that, I don't know that you should even have a job.
We were pretty split up until the last bit, where we decided that Duck would be the winner for that beautiful representation of Michael Jackson on stage.
Alright.
Wearing that outfit, I mean, that's commitment.
Alright, so final round of Bracket 1, the winner of this final round moves on to the final. We have Duck versus Becky in a Kung Fu Off.
What?
Kung Fu Off.
Did we get music for this or not?
I'm working on it.
Alright.
Oh, look.
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
It's like I'm there now.
And that would be the praying mantis. Look at those kicks. They are fast as lightning.
Wow.
They really are.
The technical execution is extraordinary.
That roundhouse kick, though, she'll lose points for that.
All right, I'm going to stop this before someone gets hurt. We don't want to, nobody should get hurt. So, judges, I need a decision. Who wins, Becky or Duck?
Oh, boy, that was a really difficult choice. However, there is only one person to whom I would kiss his Converse. It's got to be Duck Washington for this round.
Oh, all right. Well done, Becky. Well done, Duck. Duck moves on to the finals, and now we move to bracket number two. The first two competitors in bracket number two, Aaron versus Aiden. And the Kung Fu Off has been taken. So the two of you must face off in a school off.
Teacher. Billy was kicking me.
Well, it seems like you and Billy need to have a conversation. Come on. Billy? Jean? Well, the important thing to do is talk about your feelings. Now, I want you to look at Billy and talk to him. Tell him exactly what he did that hurt you.
Billy, you pulled my hair, and I think you're an asshole.
Now, Billy, you see what happened there? You did something that hurt Jean's feelings. Now, how would you feel if you had somebody pull your hair? Yeah, you'd probably feel really bad. Now, back to calculus. So...
All right, judges. Who won that comedy battle?
I'm sorry. It's like it's a set spike right over the net with calculus. What else can you say about that?
Aaron wins, but Aiden moves on to the loser bracket. I'm sorry, the consolation bracket. My fault. It's not the loser bracket. Jesse versus Khadijah. Excuse me. You are going to be in a shop off.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
All right. First off, Walmart is not where you start. Target isn't even there. All right?
But I can only fit things at Walmart. I can't fit things at Target.
Oh, sweetheart, there's Lane Bryant and Torrid. Jesus, come on.
That's where I need to go.
Let's go.
All right.
Do
you think they'll have, like, flower patterns? I really like flower patterns.
Oh, sweetheart, your skin tone right now is so much better than flower patterns. Girl, you got it going on. You got some shimmer.
Oh, my God. Thank
you. The glisten of your hair and the eye color right alone, you could totally rock some.
Thank you. I love it when I walk into a store and somebody who wanted to be a fashion designer just ended up working at Lane Bryant. That's so awesome because they're the most helpful.
Look, don't judge me because of my parents were stupid. And they
weren't really stupid. They just were poor too.
That's all right. Everybody has to have ambitions. This is like the second best thing.
Look, I made it to assistant manager. Still second best.
I'll take all of these. You can ring them up and bag them up for me. Thank you so much. And what is your name? Jesse. I'm going to fill out that survey for sure.
All right, judges.
It's funny because it's true. Paris Fashion Week Lane Bryant shopping clerk. Thank you very much, Khadijah.
Is that your decision?
Yes, that is our decision.
Khadijah wins.
Yeah.
All right. Well done. Jesse, you have a chance to come back in the consolation bracket. We move on to Lauren and Eric. Woo! You'll be competing in a poetry off.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that your eyes were as sweet as the morning dew. Oh, that your hair shimmered in the sunlight like spun corn silk. But you are not that woman.
You say you like my hair, but do you stare? No. You say you like my eyes, but these thighs? No.
Okay, judges.
What?
Who won the poetry off?
Well, we would have to say that these thighs just know that Lauren won.
Yeah. All right, Lauren, well done. Eric moving on into the consolation bracket. And now, finally, we have Salsa versus Jenny. And they're competing in a math off. A math off, preferably calculus.
X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared. No. B squared over 2ac. All over 2a. Close.
Yeah.
Nerd. 3.141592.
3.141592653589 7 9 3.141592653589 7 9 3 2 3 6 4
What
can I say?
Pretty much
a
nerd.
Yeah.
Judges?
She wins.
Yeah.
You don't have to think about that one.
All right.
What was her name again?
Jenny.
Jenny. You rock.
Right. Time for round true bracket two. Aaron versus Khadijah. Khadijah. Aaron and Khadijah are going to compete.
I listened well. I was just like in the corner.
This is perfect. I think you two will do well. This is the awkward off.
I've been doing pageants since I was 3. I've been wearing eyelashes since I was 2. And little prosthetics. And if I don't hit my mark, my mother for sure won't give me my Mountain Dew and pixie sticks. So, bam! Just like that.
Right, if I don't stop this, somebody's going to call the cops.
Let's keep going.
Judges!
Is my mom here?
What's happening?
I'll help you.
This seems to be resolved.
Oh, wow.
are we judging them based on how awkward we feel?
Make eye contact with the Can I go?
Yes, yes, judges, please. Let's put them out of their own misery.
And, I think this needs to keep going.
No!
You asked for it!
I have a solution. This was absolutely fantastic, and in the spirit of awkwardness, I insist that the two of you compete in the next round together.
All right.
Yeah! That is so let it be written, so let it be done.
That's the exit side. Yeah, you go on that side. No, that way. You'll be back in the next round.
And I want you to play these characters in the
next we have Lauren and Jenny. Lauren and Jenny. In the exact opposite of what we just experienced. They'll be doing a Disney off.
Yeah!
Disney off. All right, judges. Now, on the surface, it may seem obvious who won, but this, of course, is a comedy duel. So, who emerged victorious in our Disney off?
What's your names again?
I'm Lauren.
Lauren and?
Jenny.
Lauren, I loved your performance there. I loved your rendition of, what character was that?
All of them.
Oh. Beautifully done. Lauren's the winner.
Lauren wins. Well done, Jenny. Great job. Now we have Aaron and Khadija against Lauren. In a game show off.
Just to see that they exist.
one. Thanks, Bob.
Okay.
Is the camera still on me? Because I'm not sure if I should be doing something on it.
No, we're live. On TV.
I once had a dog. I named it Ham because I thought that it would be a great thing to bring out on Easter, but then Grandma ate him.
All right, judges, I think we have to figure out the winner of this. Who won the...
Of course, I want a season of this shit. I don't even... I want to see this on Netflix.
This is hard.
In the spirit... no,
never
I can't,
ham
I can't
on
say...
Easter
one of these
again.
People I perform with, I can't... In the spirit...
I think the winners are the American viewing public here with us tonight. Is this the final of the consolation round?
But this is the final of bracket nine.
They are absolutely all the winners tonight. They are coming back to face the final champion.
God, they're all going to the finals. All of them.
I agree completely.
And all right.
What the fuck was that?
We're moving on to the consolation.
But if
bracket.
They no, let me stop. If they come back, they have to have the same characters from the first one, and they also have to be in a game show in the second one. So. Awkward game show,
right,
whatever
we're
else you do.
The consolation bracket, and this will never end. Kyle and Jason.
I got fucking. In the consolation bracket, we're only singles ever.
Yeah.
You have to compete in a science off.
Yeah.
You see, if you could hyperspace a ship to kill a Star Destroyer, why do they just put droids in X-Wings the first place and blow up the Death Star in the first movie?
Maybe because they can't track through hyperspace?
Well, you know, you're not the only person whose childhood was ruined by Rian Johnson. I'm just saying that if a droid can fly a ship, why don't they have them do it?
Bad storytelling? Not everything is like in the movies. Also, I thought this was a science off, not a Star Wars off. If you look at the rules, it will dictate that one, do the off that you are given. You can read. You're smart. I thought this was just... show who's the bigger nerd, because that's what science means, right? I'm a man. I have to know science.
Here, drink this. I think it'll turn you into something. Oh, hi. Steve. Oh, you here for the lecture on the solar system and, you know, comets and stuff?
I've learned how to distill intelligence.
Say something.
Well, in the amount of time it takes for light to get from a star to us, we'll all be dead.
Sure,
buddy. Okay, now we're going to stop right there. That's all that really matters at this point. Judges, who won the science off?
Nobody.
Let's just put them all in.
Kyle.
Yeah. Who?
What?
Kyle.
Kyle wins the science off. He moves on.
You know, it is true, in the time it takes for the light from the sun to reach us, we die.
It's true.
Yeah.
Garrick and John. Garrick and John, you are going to compete in a compliment off.
Yeah!
Yes, sir. Yes, you and your fabulous beard.
Your beard is also truly magnificent.
Oh, no, sir. Sir, your beard with its curls and its fluffiness, like a duck's bottom, a baby duckling's bottom.
Well, it's true. Your eyes are so luminous, they make the moon look unluminous.
Ah, but not quite like yours, sir, which sparkle like the evening stars around Orion's belt.
Your buttocks are so supple and firm, they remind me of two hams that I would love to gnaw upon.
Sir, your bulging biceps have the strength and power of Hercules and would make a man feel safe whilst wrapped inside them.
Your kneecaps are so firm, you can walk up and downstairs with no pain.
All right, I think we'll stop here. Judges.
More than anything else, this was like the opposite of vilification tennis, and therefore very entertaining. But I have to say, just for wonderful work, both of you, but just for the obscurity of the things you chose, Garrick really captured my heart with
all
this
right,
one. Thank you.
Pick for the kneecaps. All right. Victory. Well done, John. Next up, we have Aiden and Jesse.
They are supple. They are.
They are going to compete in a fear-off.
What?
A fear-off.
All right, so this is going to sound really, really stupid, but I can't even go to North Dakota. Do you know why?
What? There's a North Dakota?
Yeah.
I can't even deal with the regular one.
Oh, please. The biggest pinwheels live there. North Dakota, South Dakota, California. I can't even travel outside my backyard.
Pinwheels?
There's one in Anoka.
Those things could fly off and, like, kill cows.
You know what? Everybody laughs at me. But you know what the funny thing is? Is there's actually an actual report. An actual report of one going right through a window and almost slaughtering somebody. So really, who's irrational? What's the fear?
Farmers. Farmers are irrational. That's who.
They are, actually.
We should end all farmers.
Go organic.
I don't like that word.
No,
that word's scary.
That's GMOs.
GMOs are bad.
That's scary.
I read it on Breitbart.
Is that where you got this photo?
Okay, we're going to stop there. Judges, who won?
Well,
the fear off.
The thing is that the fear that there was actually a North Dakota out there won me over, Aiden.
Yeah, great.
So we're giving that to Aiden? Aiden, all right. Now we have Eric versus Salsa.
Woo!
In a melodrama off.
Oh, God.
Do we really have to do this again?
Seriously?
My God, why with this guy, I thought I was finally. And what do we have? Him standing over here looking like this.
Wine, 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 constantly whining. No. I gotta listen to you all the time. That's all you do. Why do I gotta do this? Why do I gotta do that? Seriously, it's like living with a child. An old child.
Please, just put us out of our misery. Now.
Oh, this makes me nauseous.
Okay. Let's put them out of their misery, judges.
Well, despite the seeming pandering at the end, Eric, I really felt like I was inside of an episode of All My Children, and for that, I will give you that point. I think the other judges agree with me.
That was great. That was a soap opera. Kyle and Garrick, return to the stage, please. The two of you are going to compete in a monologue off.
Oh, boy.
Stardate 4772. The women of
there once was a time, a little old man came upon another little old man, and they got together and they decided what they really needed was a third.
Even though it was just for science,
so what
they
walked, and they walked, and they walked some more until they came upon a little old lady. They said, "No, we don't want you. You're not the right type." So they kept on walking and walking and walking until they came upon Godzilla. And they said that you are not also the right type, so they kept walking. And you stopped talking, so I think that means I.
All right, let's stop there. Judges, who won that monologue off?
Yeah, sorry, Kyle.
All right. How amazing would it have been if they had both said Godzilla at the same time?
Oh, the things that could have happened. It's time for Aiden versus Eric.
Woo!
You two will be competing in a superhero off.
Yeah! I am Great Man. What are you?
I am Greater Man.
Oh, shit.
Greater than any other superhero by just that much.
Well, you see,
it does not matter how powerful you are and what your power is, I am always just slightly better at it than you.
Well, see,
but only against you.
As Great Man, I have this belt here, this utility belt, and it has this juice in it. You see this? That makes me Greatest Man! I am way better than Greater Man.
Curses. I may have been turned into Failure Man. If things don't turn out my way, Failure Man may become a villain.
My arch enemy.
I will take you down.
Where are we going? Is there a nice place downtown?
It's a nightclub.
Ooh, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Yes.
Is it a gay club? Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Wait, that's very judgy of you.
No, I mean, so we're gonna go, or you wouldn't go.
Yeah. Like, all right, sure.
Okay. I believe that as soon as they got off stage, they would have started an awkward off. So.
Oh, we already hit that.
Yeah. Judges, who won that superhero off?
Well, when both fear and success become friends, we are all winners. However, I do believe in this case that Eric took the cake.
Yeah. Eric took the cake.
Wow.
And it's now Eric versus Garrick.
Wait, there's cake?
Yes. You are competing in my favorite contest. That's right. It is a pork off.
Pork
off.
Chewy shifted. That's comedy from Disney.
All right, judges.
I think we're done.
Yeah.
Well played.
Yeah, well done.
Sorry, Tim.
Garrick won that one.
I look forward to a three-part novel series in the extended universe where we find out that pork's backstory.
It's time for the finals. We have Duck. Duck versus Aaron. And Lauren. And Garrick. They are going to play three rounds with the judges determining. Wait, we have one more. Khadija. Yeah. Yes. Okay, so here's how it's going to work. We're going to play three rounds.
No. Okay, wait. Sorry. We need to make sure that this is clear. This is you three against you and him. This is not five. This is three versus one versus one.
Okay. That seems kind of unfair, but I'm not sure in what way.
Life is unfair.
The first round is a Minnesota Nice off.
Yeah.
Oh, we should bring the boys some casserole, yeah? We should.
Oh, God. Okay, but if we go, then we need to have a pancake social first.
You're so right.
Okay.
Yeah.
You go ahead. You go right on ahead.
Oh, no.
He's after you,
I ain't seen.
Oh, no. No, I couldn't possibly go first.
I
really think that Garrick should be the first one, you know? I mean,
well, okay, only if we go to that new lake named Lake that I can't remember the new name.
Excuse me, sir. I understand that you have a place to go, but when you walk through a table, that's just rude.
Don't forget to take your load of fans!
Oh, yeah, I'm saying bye.
Oh, it was really great to handle.
That's it, you're going to visit.
Oh, I'm not going anywhere. No, no, I'm going to stay. Oh, of course I'm going to stay.
Oh, Michael,
okay,
he's leaving.
No, he's going to
see. Oh, I got to go.
I really feel bad if I'm leaving.
Oh, hey, how are you? Yeah, I know. But I got to go because we have this stuff to do.
Man, you know, it would have been so fun if we were
quiet. This is literally every holiday I experience growing up. Okay, we're gonna stop. I think we have to, because he's never gonna leave. It's never gonna happen. All right, judges, I want you to think about that. I want you to percolate on that.
Is there another round after this?
Yeah, there are two more rounds. The next round is a chicken off.
I just have a question. I'm just wondering, is this something that, you know, all of us are going to stick around for? Because if we are, I think there are some people who would like to make sure that their voices are heard the loudest.
Okay, we voted on the girls, but if you want to just keep talking, that's fine.
I can still do that. Are we still doing the Minnesota off? I was being as passive aggressive as possible.
Oh, it wasn't passive.
They competed three rounds and then you decided.
Sure, okay.
Are we eliminating somebody right now? Or?
No. They're going to compete in a chicken off.
Well, you see, the thing there is that I really felt like I was back home in Duluth, and I'd really like to be able to invite you all to the Lutheran Church, but I think you ladies would fit in the best there, so I'm going to go with you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, so
I'd be upset with you, but I'm not.
Okay, so we've got the ladies in the lead, but we still have two more rounds before we crown a winner. So next we're going to do a chicken off. Whatever that means.
Wait, I'm not a chicken, I'm a hound dog.
Okay, we're going to stop right there. That just was dangerous, what happened there. All right, judges, what did you think about that round? This is only the second round.
I don't know.
That was something. Yeah, eggs.
And those are new jeans.
I have to say, I really enjoyed the musical rendition during the song. Yeah. That's what captured my attention.
Yeah.
Oh, I get it. It just clicked now because it's chicken.
Yes. Brilliant work. I had to take a few points away because very clearly you were egg binding. But yeah, Duck, your rendition of I Believe I Can Fly was amazing.
Okay, so we got one more round and then we have to crown a final winner. Unless anybody else had anything to share, any thoughts, judges? All right. Final round, I think we have to go with what our final round was last year. That's right, it's time for a dance off.
Yeah.
So here we go.
I can move mountains, I can work a miracle, work a miracle.
So we can see a bit of Running Man there.
She wants to dance like ooh, I'm burning. Bury me till I confess. She wants to dance like ooh, I'm burning.
I'm worried at some point somebody won't be able to stand up anymore. So,
yeah.
Judges, we are at the end of our time. We need to pick a winner.
You, yeah. You watch these classic movie musicals, and some idiot will always say, "Oh, and everybody just knew how to do all the choreography." Well, here you go, motherfuckers. Right here on this stage.
We have a trio of winners in this year's comedy fight. Can we bring all of our fighters out on stage?
Yeah.
Lauren and Aaron. Thank you very much. Thank you to our judges, Brian, Chad, Allison, and Bill. And we might see you next year, or we might not. And thank you very much to Bill's Comedy Productions. Congratulations to our winners. And we're going to get the hell out of here. So Matt, come out here and get us. We want to be done. Matt, you're not going to the bathroom again, are you, Matt? We're gonna have a Madoff.
A Rachel Madoff?
I don't want to go on a Madoff.
Well, that was an anticlimactic ending.
We could have done another awkward off.
What?
This is our awkward off. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sorry, I was watching the box office and there's like a 20-second delay. So we're all like, holy shit, everybody did the splits! And then it was like, you're supposed to be on stage. And then someone handed me my things. Hi, I'm a professional.